All right. So our last lightning talk is Stefano Babic, and he will talk about SW update over Canvas.
Okay, thank you all. So just a note about me. So I'm a freelance embedded developer. I'm working mostly for Denk's system engineer in Germany. I am maintainer for the NXP processor, the IMX for U-Boot. But my point, so the point of this presentation is about update. I'm an author and maintainer of SW Update. Is one of the update agent for embedded Linux. So just to say what is SW Update. SW Update is an update agent. So after your build in Yotto, Debian, or whatever you are using, you have to put all together all your artifacts, so to pack, and SW Update provide a way to pack all together and to install at the end on your embedded Linux device. So supports any kind of storage, embedded storage, MVC, run-end, no flash, whatever. You can update the firmware of connecting microcontroller to the main Linux processor. There's different supporting interface for SW Update, like an integrated web server. There's a fleet management. This is the OP server. You can directly download from an external server, or you can use any local interface. Signing, encryption, and so on are supported as security into SW Update. The point is now moving to another type of bus, that means on the vehicle CAN bus. So SW Update was also used on some devices, but really there's no big difference with the standard in SW Update usage, because the device is still connected with a mobile network like LTE or whatever to an external device. The running stack is based on TCP IP as well. So really this is not the big difference that I have. So what I want to show is my short experience in a project. I have to update an embedded Linux device. This is a part, was on a track, and this was an ECU, and the only connection is the CAN bus. So you can access to the device via OBD2, or there's also a over the air, but at the end, the ECU is connected just via CAN bus. So we have some difference. So I have no TCP. The most problematic is the CAN bandwidth on the CAN bus with just 215 kilohertz and 8-bit payload. There's no way, at least in my project, to switch to a higher frequency for the CAN bus because there's a lot of older devices connected to the CAN bus, and nobody knows what happened if a frequency was changed. The ECU that I have had also a small display because it was to control something for a refrigerator. And there's a Qt application, so the size is not so small, it's 140 megabytes. Reason to do this via CAN bus is because there's the only interface available. There's require a lot of effort to unmount the device, the ECU, and to put in a safe environment just for updated. And there's also the necessity to have a over the air, not done directly to the embedded Linux device, but there is something on the track that can connect over the air, and then the update package should be transferred via CAN bus. There's some requirement to transfer on the CAN bus. So one point is how we get the CAN address for the ECU. This is done via the J939. And you can understand, the update packages are big, so there's the necessity to transfer big packages over the CAN bus, and this is done via the ISO TP specification. that allows to put together, to manage fragmentation, and to have messages bigger than 8 bytes. On the top of this two specification, the transfer to the ECU is done using Unix diagnostic services, that is the interface to the application. So when I take this, there's just other constraints, because yes, I can propose a lot of things, but in the automotive, is quite conservative, so I cannot use whatever I want. Both J939 and ISO-TP are part of the kernel. There's a lot of very nice work in the kernel, and this, I think, still kernel 5.6 was mainline. I could use this just in a hybrid approach, so I can use the J939 from kernel for address claiming and get the address of the ECU, but for ISO-TP and UDS, I have to use a customer library, because my customer has already used this, and they have done also some certification. So this is what is a realization at the end. So there's underlying kndriver, we have a J939 still in the kernel, ISO-TP and UDS as part of a process communicating with the rest, and a small part, I call them this UDS proxy, communicate with a real UDS application in the ECU, and STV Update provides also a library to send the package and to monitor the package, so to monitor how an update is going on. So incoming packages, incoming comments from the CAN bus are then forwarded to the SW updates if they are related to the update. And to do this, there are some comments in UDS that can be used. That means all messages that are not part of this list are transferred or forwarded to the UDS application of ECU, and this is intercepted and sent to SW Update. First, there's a request download. Request download is more or less to check if check precondition and check if an update can take place. So, just for check and test if can go on. Second is a request file transfer. In UDS is used to put a file into a file system of ECU. In this case, it's not used at all. It's just because SW Update is working as streamer, so in zero copy, so you don't need to put the incoming stream, the incoming package into the file system. Everything is installed on the fly. So this is just used to trigger an update. So SW Update knows something is coming. Then there's a lot of transfer data, of course, so the whole package is passed. To close the transaction for the transfer, we request transfer exit, and this close the transfer, but at this point, the update is already installed by SW Update, and it's also request because the activation of the software should be done in a controlled way, so the system does not reboot automatically, but there's an additional UDS command, is routine control, and this says SW Update, okay, now it's time to restart the application. Just to give you some time, of course, requires a lot of time. If everything is transferred, requires 9 hours. This is not used, or I think is used just in vehicle workshop, so when for service. But the usual way is to transfer just the application. The update takes 10 minutes. The way is to split between application and OS. Libraries are part of OS. As I said, also the Qt libraries are part of OS. They need to make some consistency check, and well, to be sure that the application is compliant with the libraries. So this is what is done in SWData. Everything is then managed by SWData. There's a four partition. Everything is managed in AB approach. So there's two partition for OS, two for the application. And there's a priority that when an OS is updated, it contains the application, and the two other partition for the application are not used until, of course, a new application will be updated. This is just what is done inside the SW data, so inside our SW package. Really, there's some hooks, so there's the possibility to have code inside our package that is handled by SW update, and in this way is check which is the right partition to be updated, and so on and so on. So to summarize, so sites is always a challenge because the CAN bus cannot do anymore. In any case, there's an increased number of Linux ECU, so the update process should be done, and as I said, also just via ACI. And how it can be optimized depends really from the whole environment. So as I said, I could not do a lot more. There are some way to have some kind of delta update. This is also what is done, splitting application and OS. Thank you very much.